Right whales migrate from high-latitude productive feeding areas to resource-poor breeding grounds. Every year, they gather at protected shallow bays around the world looking for calm water to breathe, give birth, and raise their calf. For the last 50 years, we have learned about their biology, ecology, and population dynamics. But what do we know about whales and climate change?
Whales play critical roles in marine ecosystems. They enhance primary production by fertilizing the ocean with nutrients from their feces. They are huge, and they live long lives, so they incorporate tons of carbon into their bodies. So we know that whales help to mitigate climate change. But the question now is, how is climate change impacting the whales?
The Right Whale Program has monitored individual southern right whales at their calving ground in Peninsula Valdez, Argentina. With more than 4,000 known individuals, this research program has created an exceptionally long database.
We analyzed 5 decades of individual recognition data, and we found a killing between El Niño events and whale survival. The results lead to a worrying conclusion. Female mortality increased following a strong El Niño events, and this can delay or even impede whale population recovery.
One of the principal findings of the study was that following strong El Niño events, a high proportion of females were missing from their breeding site. Well, why is this? Well, previous research has shown us that El Niño is also associated with a reduction in the abundance of Antarctic krill, one of the principal prey species of southern right whales.
We know that whales lose at least 25% of their body volume during the first phase of lactation. So after 1 year of gestation, followed by 1 year of lactation, reproductive females are vulnerable to the reduced availability of krill, and they may possibly fail to fully recover.
Whale populations have been recovering after centuries of exploitation. Now they are facing new threats such as ship strikes, entanglement in fishing gear, microplastic, and even gull harassment. These threats can affect their survival and consequently their future recovery.
The study reveals how important it is to consider the effect of climate change on whale populations. And for the first time, we've been able to find a link between whale survival and El Niño events. And this link allowed us to project future whale population recovery in different scenarios of climate change mitigation.
Our findings suggest that stronger El Niño events may lead to a marked decrease in population growth. We are facing a future with a more intense global warming, and we need to bear in mind that a delay in whale population recovery has the potential to disrupt food web interaction in the Southern Ocean.
The results reported in this paper reinforce the importance of maintaining continuous individual recognition databases. Our long-term study in Argentina has given us a unique opportunity to greatly increase our understanding of the challenges individual whales confront during different stages of their lives and the impacts of climate change on whale populations worldwide.
When we talk about climate change, we usually think about impacts and damage, but these changes have also promoted new habits and practices. I am referring to contact people from different places searching for solutions. We wanted to come up with a study to encourage conservationists, stakeholders, and politicians to work together with scientists and take a collaborative action on whale population recovery and climate change mitigation.
Right whales are the sentinels of the oceans. They can help us respond to threats created by climate change, especially for the world's ocean. Taking action to protect the whales will also protect ocean biodiversity at large.